In the energy quadrant today, taking a look at the August crude oil, WTI futures hit a six-year high, highest level since November of 2014, falling just short of $77 a barrel. $76.97.5 was the high in that August crude, 242. That was 2.42% higher than the settlement last week. Now on the downside, we're actually down 2.96%. That's because it was not a sustained rally. Crude fell toward the rest of the day. That was really an overnight high, that $76.98 high that I mentioned. $73.50 was near the settlement, approximate settlement, down 2.2%. And I mentioned the low was actually below $73. $72.92.5 was down 2.96% on the day. Now, summer demand has been robust. That summer driving season had gasoline demand on Friday before the July 4th weekend hit a new post-COVID high, surging by about 9.3%, according to GasBuddy.com from the previous Friday. Now that's pretty strong demand. The national price for gasoline is up 2.5 cents per gallon in the last week at an average of 3.09 cents. So $3.09 per gallon. And that's the highest since June 28th of 2014. Now all that demand not really spurring OPEC yet. The UAE is still blocking a production increase. And if this feud is not settled, which is basically between the UAE and Saudi Arabia, then there may be no production increase for August, which could push prices even higher. Although we're not seeing that now, market clearly believes there will be some sort of agreement. Iraq is hoping for new talks about 10 days after this weekend meeting, which kind of broke down. Nothing has been settled yet. And so far, no production, although the market backing off, potentially responding to the weaker ISM data that we saw, and maybe even the Delta variants that we're seeing in the COVID-19 crisis, which is still ongoing in some of the larger nations in terms of oil demand.